Hello and welcome to Meshtup. In our previous video, I have given you an introduction of how to make our design sustainable. And in this video, we will discuss about how to make our design physically sustainable. So before starting this video, let me discuss about what is green material. Now, green material are those material which are first recyclable, second renewable, third non-toxic, and fourth have less embodied energy. We have discussed about embodied energy in our previous video. So without any further ado, let's get started. To select greener material, you need to consider the material's environmental cost and performance impact on your design. A material performance depends on its physical properties, and optimizing this is the most important way to reduce your product's environmental impact. Energy use often causes the biggest environmental impact for the product that consumes much energy during their use, like refrigerator and car. So suppose I want to make a car and I came across two types of material, first aluminium and second steel. So as we know that aluminium has 6 times more embodied energy per kg than steel, which means that it is 6 times bad, right? Not necessary, because aluminium is 2.5 times stronger than steel, which means that I can make lighter chassis with the help of aluminium, and creating a lighter weight car can save far more energy than reducing the embodied energy of its material. Likewise, to make a refrigerator more energy efficient, you will need to have good insulation and optimize heat transfer. A simple way to choose material which are physically sustainable for your product is to run software simulation. And software simulation is valuable because some of these matrices like force, torque, pressure, etc. are often impossible to calculate by hand for even simple mechanical systems. And understanding deformation and modes of failure is a major goal of simulation. A good analysis can help you answer questions like, will your design stand up to the load it will experience in everyday use? Second, what about the worst case scenario? Third, can you reduce the weight and amount of material in your design? And to really understand simulation result, you need a solid understanding of following basics metrics that the software consider, including force, torque, pressure, stress, strain, etc. And I will try to explain these matrices as fast as possible because it is not a technical class and I believe that you are from science background. So first let us talk about force. So force is basically the push or pull on any object. Pressure is simply force applied over an area. Torque is essentially the amount of twisting force on an object at a point. Stress can be thought of the internal reaction to forces on an object. Strain is the measure of the deformation of a material. Now, another important topic is factor of safety. The factor of safety of a design is an easy to understand and very important number. It is found by dividing the maximum stress possible in the system by the maximum expected load. For instance, if the material yields 20 MPa and the maximum expected stress for a given design is 2 MPa, then the factor of safety is 10, which means the design would survive stresses up to 10 times the maximum expected stresses. Now, different application will often have different factor of safety. For example, building may use factor of safety of 2 for their structure member, while the factor of safety in aircraft may be lower, often 1.5. Okay, so when designing, a large factor of safety can be an indication that you could save money and weight by reducing the amount of material used. So to decrease factor of safety, you can use thinner parts or cutouts. Understanding these principles along with other aspects that can affect failures such as corrosion and rusting can help prevent your product being sent to an early grave. And in selecting material, trade-offs are inevitable. But you can more confidently make right decision when you know what aspects of your design is most important to optimize. Using the right tool and understanding material property will help you to make a far more sustainable design decision. If you are confused in how to choose any material for any of your product, then you can simply refer to the Ashby diagram. Now, what is Ashby diagram? Ashby diagram is a simple graph between strength and density. I will discuss about this diagram in a separate video. So, as it comes to sustainability, how your product ends its life is often as important as how it lives. And that's exactly what we will look at next. So, up to then, stay safe, stay tuned, and thank you.